Planet Earth. Home. We crack it open. What's inside? It's beautiful to look at, but what's inside? We're going to study now Earth's interior. There's three layers, and again, you can get into more complexity than this. But three essential layers here that we're going to study, one, two, and three. You should know a little bit about each one of them and how they're connected and what they do, what's going on. Not too much, and I've got it outlined here. But the first question you might say, well, if I crack this open, is the interior here hot or cold? I mean, some people say, wow, it's cold as hell. So is hell cold? It's hot as hell. People used to think that inside Earth was some hell, right? You can look up Dante's Inferno and the different layers of so on. So is it hot down there or is it cold? I mean, how would you know? How would you know? Turns out to be very important, and it affects everything, all those six layers that Earth is. Hot inside. Quite hot inside. So let's talk about these layers and take a look, and let's take Earth and let's crack it open. What would happen if you cracked it open? Well, it doesn't look much like Earth, but it's a picture of Earth. And if you did, you'd find these layers. And this would be the right size, relatively. So smaller here, I would make that probably black or something. Black, gray, kind of this too, and red. And we'll talk about these layers. So just know enough. Let's know about these layers, that's what you get. And then the next question you might ask, well, we'll get to that later. But you're standing here on your surface. You can't look down, so how do we know this stuff? Turns out to be very important. So let's take a closer look at the details. As you know, the glory is in the details. Okay. Let's come over here. It's also good to outline things. So we've got the solid inner core. So who would know inside? Is it solid? Is it hollow? I mean, you could guess all day. Maybe you've heard it, but how do people find it? It's solid. This is solid. This is liquid. Wait, there's something solid inside and liquid around it. Like liquid what? Solid inner core. The most inside, I've just drawn here as a quarter circle. Solid, liquid, outer core, and something called the mantle. And I'll tell you what that means in a minute. But the mantle. And then we'll have the surface and the atmosphere, the magnetosphere. Okay, so let's talk about what's going on in each of these layers. And it's going to change our perspective a little bit. Come over here. Let's focus on that solid inner core. Get rid of this guy. And there's your notes. There are your notes. The solid inner core. What's going on? What is that? Down deep, beneath your feet, beneath my feet, beneath our feet. Go down, down, down. And what you'll find is a hot, solid, metal ball, mostly iron. I think of it like a cannonball. Beneath our feet, down one layer, another layer, down to the deepest layer, there's a cannonball inside of Earth. That's so weird. So a cannonball, mostly iron, Fe stands for iron, ferrous, iron. And so what happened? So this is the key thing. You can't think of Earth as always being there. We've got to continue to challenge the old perspective, the old simple notion, you know, of everything going around us and so on, going from geocentric to now heliocentric. Earth hasn't always been here. Things haven't always been here. We'll talk about how Earth got here a little more in chapter 7. But Earth came together from bits, gravity, and bits built up this little grain of sand, right? This little pale blue dot. Gravity pulled these bits together. And important, as it came together, things fell, and they rubbed, and they sifted, and they sorted. So that's important. Earth hasn't always been here. It got the way it is. The atmosphere wasn't always like this. It got this way. There weren't always mountains. They got there. So it's a process. And you might say, well, why is there metal in the middle of Earth? Well, because as Earth formed, the heavy stuff, really the more dense, more packed in stuff, if you take a piece of metal and you throw it in the water, it's going to sink, right? So the heavy or dense stuff was pulled in and sank to the center. This is called planetary differentiation. It's a process that we use to think about the other planets as well. Heavy, dense, really stuff, sank to the middle. That's called planetary differentiation, meaning different layers. It's like a layered cake, or pour water and you pour oil and you'll see it layer out and you can do different layers. So we've got a layered pastry here called Earth. Keep it simple, but know that we've got metal in the middle and it sank. And you go, well, why is it solid? When it's really hot, you know, if you make anything really hot, the solid will get liquid. Why is this one solid? And the answer's simple. It was squeezed. If you take water vapor, gas, and you put it in a container and you squeeze it, keeping the same temperature even, you squeeze it, you can even make it hot, which makes water vapor, right, steam. You squeeze it, the water droplets start bonding to each other and the gas turns into a liquid. And so you can imagine that process where you squeeze more and more and the liquid bonds into more solid connections, making a solid. And so, again, without getting too much detail, this gives you a good sense, a good way of thinking, and a good start. Metal sank to the center, planetary differentiation. That stuff all above it, around it, pulled down by gravity, squeezes it into a solid cannonball, and it's hot. So why is it hot? This is what you should know, because we're gonna use this as a reference. We're gonna check about Earth, Moon, Mercury, Venus, Mars, check these things, other moons, hot. So two questions to answer. How did it get hot? And why is it still hot? Super important. Trust me, okay? Know this so we can think about other worlds as well. So how did it get hot? Friction. As Earth formed, stuff fell, pulled together, sorted out, rubbed each other, and you go like this, your hands get warm, right? Friction. So the friction of formation, in formation, Earth got hot, okay? Also, some atoms, usually the bigger atoms, like uranium, the centers of the atoms, the nucleus, have nuclear fission, that is the radioactive decay. And so things like uranium will decay, and some things that they can break off pieces, and some of that creates helium. So we can have helium coming from radioactive decay, but helium doesn't bother our bodies. Radioactive decay. And when that happens, there's a lot of energy released, if you will. There's a lot of warming to that. And it can make things very warm. Radioactive decay can. So we've got radioactive material, like uranium, think that. Go into it more if you want. And it can decay, and it can warm Earth, turning solids into liquids. Fission and formation. Friction in formation, rubbing, and nuclear fission, both creating warming. Now, why is Earth still, if that happened when Earth formed, back when our solar system formed, same time, 4.6 billion years ago, you know that number, when Earth formed, it was warm. How come it hasn't cooled off? Why is it still hot? And the answers are two main ones that I'm going to focus on here is the size. Larger objects retain their heat longer. Imagine a pot of coffee and a cup of coffee. Now, the pot of coffee has more warm stuff inside. And compared to all that warm stuff inside, it's got a smaller surface compared to there's so much warm stuff inside. Whereas a cup of coffee doesn't have as much hot stuff inside. And so a cup of coffee is going to cool faster than a pot of coffee. A larger world will stay warmer longer than a smaller world. And you know where I'm going. Also, if it's larger, you're going to have more radioactive material. And so, odds are, right? And so if you've got more radioactive material, it can stay radioactive and continue warming. So we still have nuclear. Beneath your feet, there's a giant cannonball, you know, down at the greatest depths, and there's radioactivity going on. Oh no, yeah, what's going on? But you're okay, you're shielded by some stuff, but things to learn about. So how it got hot, why it got hot, why it's solid, why there's metal in the middle. So I like to think of this. It's a big, solid cannonball inside Earth. And it layered, it sorted out planetary differentiation. So what's the next layer on top? Well, the next layer on top is a liquid outer core, solid inner core, most inside, liquid outer core, and Earth spinning, that combination is going to create magnetism right there. That's the key thing that you need to remember about this one. Okay? So let's lay out all you gotta know there. I just said it, really. Let's go over here and see it in list. All right. The second layer from the inside is a hot liquid metal. What kind of metal? Mostly iron, some nickel as well, and iron can be magnetized. And you might think, is our magnetism coming from that cannonball? No, it's a complicated process, so you could dig into this quite a lot. But the first pass of understanding is that iron can be magnetized. Earth's spin rotates the liquid iron. So we've got a cannonball swimming in a sea of liquid hot melted iron, right? Liquid iron. And as Earth spins around, pretty quickly, we're going to see a lot of other worlds much slower. Pretty quickly, that combination, spinning Earth and liquid iron, produces magnetism. Magnetism is created here in this layer. Just know that. We're going to see why it's important later, but it is created there. And it goes way out. We'll talk about that later. All right, so you've got two. That's all. Just know that, but review it. Look at it each day. Don't overprocess that too much. All right, so we've got this hot interior, right? And you know why it's hot and why it's still hot. Let's come back over here to the mantle. Now, mantle, you may have heard around a fireplace. That's fire, a log, fireplace. And that's called a M-A-N-T-E-L mantle, the thing above the fireplace. And the word mantle has kind of old roots, like a vest or something around, you know, your warm body to keep it warm. So, mantle, it's something around something. Oh yeah, that's right. We said it's hot, 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 hot. I just like saying hot, hot. What's this made out of? Is that more metal? No, it's sorted out. So the dense stuff sank down, and as over geologic time, we have another layer. And you can get into the details of that layer, but we're just gonna go here and we're good. The mantle is made of hot rock. This is rock inside here. Hot rock. It's solid, but when you warm rock, it becomes a little more flexible. Now, to a human, you might still say it's solid, but to big old Earth, you know, there's some, we call it malleability, that it's softer. There can be pockets of liquid rock, as you know. You've heard of magma and lava. We'll talk about that. But what happens, and this is a process you'll see on the stovetop, we'll see it in our atmosphere, we'll see it inside stars. This is a very, very, trust me, very important. Convection, you've heard the word constellation, constella, with stars. Convection, with vector. Vector is a word for direction. Vector, with direction. What's the direction of this hot rock? Well, heated lower levels, they get heated down there, rise up. They expand, they become less dense, and they rise up. They rise up. Then when they get near the surface, they cool some. And as they cool, they kind of pack down a little more dense, and they sink back down in. And then they heat up, and they go back up. It's actually a pretty complicated process that you can use imaging and all kinds of things. It's the details are heavy details. So it's not going to be as simple as I'm about to draw it. But convection is key in a mantle. And we're going to see what it does. This is all connected. You're going to see it. In fact, that convection, that motion rising up of the warm rock, rising up, cooling, and sinking, is going to push around the surface. It'll drive plate tectonics, creating tectonic mountains and volcanic mountains and cracks. We'll get to that in a bit. Let me finish off our interior here, and that's what you need to know and think about when you look at the surface of planet Earth. That Earth is here. These layers, very good, I think, introduction. And so what you've got is this hot rock that's like sitting on the stovetop. And what happens is this is going to rise up. So I'm going to say rises. I'm going to make arrows. Rising up, going up. It's not this neat and simple, but the drawing, we've used simple drawings before. Kind of pushes on each other. Turn the corner here. That hot rock rises up. Remember, it's hot down here. And then as it's up there near the surface, it has an opportunity to, it cools, come across here, kind of dip down here, it's going to be more dense, it's going to sink. It's going to happen over here, we kind of get a little pattern going here, and we're going to do it enough times to bring out some more information. It's connected, we're not done. Cools. What cools? The hot stuff cools. So the hot stuff rises. Arrow up. Vector. Convection. Vectors like arrows. The hot stuff rises. Convection. Cools. And sinks, and that's all I need to show you what I want to show you. Good introduction to understanding geology and our world. So what happens here? Convection, make sure whatever it takes, convection with direction. Right? And what do you get out of this? Well, you get the next topic. We're going to look at the crust and surface and see what happens. And it's affected by this. How is it affected by this? Because hot stuff can come up. And you have volcanic mountains. We're going to say this again just to repeat it. So you can build up these volcanic mountains like Hawaii. But there's other ones, right? volcanic mountains. And so we've got gas, and we got lava released from this hot stuff. Now also, the surface here, you can see this, can spread. So you can push stuff up, you kind of push it up, but you can also spread it here. And have volcanic cracks. And what comes out? Gas related to our atmosphere and lava. Hot liquid rock that quickly solidifies. Often it's blasted out here, it turns into boulders in the air, solidifies and cools. And what happens here? Here we get Lake Tahoe, the Rockies. Good stuff. Himalayas. Because as this is coming this way and this is coming this way, the crust comes together, crumples up in a variety of ways that we're not getting into that detail, but let's get rid of our fireplace. We get tectonic mountains. So it's what's beneath the surface, this warm, hot stuff, driving this and changing our surface, giving us a wonderful place. I like to think of all of this connection here, how are three layers musically. And so to me, I like to think of this, where'd I go? This metal that sank down as hot, heavy metal. What do you think is coming next? Well, I think some heavy metal. And then what's next? Well, you know. Yeah, it's hot rock. Lenny Kravitz, American Woman. Doesn't get any better than that. All right, so we got heavy metal. On top of that, we've got hot rock. Now, in this little area, and I'm not going to go into it too much. You can call it the lithosphere, and you maybe you know, but it's where you have a lighter rock, and that light rock is kind of softer and smoother, kind of part of the crust too. The crust makes that up, and that upper part of the thing. So, you know, you've got your, you've got your light rock too, and the 70s are kind of big on. And then, of course, next. And I should have pulled this one up. Let me see. Let's go here. Let's do, let's go here. And, you know, there's just so much for the next layer because you've got that light rock that includes that, this surface crust. So 1, 2, 3, 4. And then what's on top of that? Well, water and atmosphere. I'll say atmosphere, and of course, you know, that's the blues. So we got that. And you're probably getting tired of me doing this, but I just can't help it. Let's see, I mean, Muddy Waters is great. You just name it, Stevie Ray Vaughan. That's great. So, you know, all good stuff. Don't go.
Oh, yeah.
So we got heavy metal, hot rock, light rock, blues.
Everything.
And then above that?
Everything gonna be all right this morning. Oh, yeah.
The Magnetosphere. I don't know how long I can play this.
Now, when I was a young boy.
All right, stop. I'm getting copyright issues. Good stuff, though. Muddy Waters. Magnetosphere. And we're going to see electrical kind of activity and stuff like that. So you can call it hip hop up here, popping around, electronic. Yeah, that's what's going on there. So anyway, we got quite the musical world. And these are the three interior layers. Let's see what the next question is on the next video and give you a taste of how we know this.